Hey there, everybody. It's Tracy from teachmetracy.com. I help parents calm the chaos and help them manage their schedule so that they can get the most enjoyment out of their life. Today's video is all about how to do your own DIY soy candle. And I've made it super, super easy. I have purchased a soy making candle kit for beginners off of Amazon, and we're going to see how it works. It's not a review, it's not a promotion. I just thought that this might be the easiest way if you were interested in becoming a candle maker. This is a fantastic way to get introduced to how to make candles, and you'll find that it's easier than you might think. If you wanted your homeschoolers to participate, these DIYs are a great way to get them involved. Just make sure that if you're dealing with any kind of equipment that is hot, you're supervising, especially with the ones that are under the age of 10. So we want to be very, very careful that they're not going to burn themselves when they're dealing with, in this case, hot wax and a double boiler situation, okay? I want to give you some expert tips concerning candles that you may not know. So you want to make sure that you stick around to the end. This kit happens to have dyes and everything else that you're gonna need as a beginning candle maker to make some impressive gifts. The one thing that you will see in this video that is not in the kit is this digital thermometer here that I use. And you can purchase this separately, also on Amazon. I'll link it down below. It's not necessary, they provide you with a candy thermometer. If you want to continue making candles, this might be something that you would want to purchase. It's a little more accurate. It has Celsius as well as Fahrenheit on it. And it's a much faster way and a more accurate way, in my opinion, to get your candle temperatures correct. So let's take a look at what this kit comes with. 4 bags of soy wax, 4 containers, 2 round and 2 square, it's a candy thermometer, some finger protectors, 4 of these warning labels, which you will need to attach to the bottom of all of your candles, 4 of these wick holders that hold your wicks in place, 4 stir sticks, you get 4 wicks, glue pieces, these hold the wicks in place so that they don't move around, 4 fragrances, so we have lavender, cinnamon vanilla, cotton clean, and coconut lime. And then there are 16 individually packaged candle dyes. The color on these candle wax dyes are very, very concentrated, so you only need a tiny sliver. So don't toss them if you intend on making more candles once you're through with this kit. It also comes with these cute jute or twine ties, and then these made with love tags, which is a cute touch also. So now that we know what's in this kit, we are going to go ahead and get our candles set up. So I'm going to show you how to do one of these, and then I'll just do the rest off camera. So you're going to take one of your glue sticks, and you're going to try to center it as much as you can in the center of your container. Once you have it placed in the center of the container, you peel the little tab off of it. Then you're going to stick the wick right on top of that glue dot and kind of press on it a little bit. Okay, that's going to hold your glue in place. And I have already attached the warning label to the bottom. You want to make sure you do this prior to pouring candles. So this is our candle setup. And then once you get your wick in place and your sticker on the bottom, you're going to put these wick holders in place. And you don't want to skip this step, because this actually holds your wick in place so that it doesn't move around when you're pouring the wax. And I just kind of folded it over there to make sure that it's nice and straight inside there. Hopefully you can see how nice and straight that wick is. Now that our candle is set up, we would take one of these bags, which has, they have it nicely separated here into 4 8-ounce bags. of soy wax and they're flakes, so they should melt fairly easily. So we're gonna pour them into this candle making tin, and then we're gonna put them in a double boiler setup. A couple of DIYs ago, when we were doing our lip balm, we talked about what a double boiler setup was. And a double boiler is nothing more than hot water in one pan, and then you're going to, when the water boils, you're going to set your candle pot down into that boiling water pot. This is why I said if you're working with children, you need to make sure that you're monitoring so that they don't burn themselves, because you're dealing with boiling water and hot candle wax. So you're just going to stir until all the wax is melted. So we're not quite there yet. You can see some flakes still. So we're going to keep going until all of the wax is melted. And while your wax is melting, feel free to set up your other candles if you intend on making other candles. This first candle that I wanted to make was the cinnamon and vanilla. I combined the orange with some brown, and we're gonna see how well that color turns out. So you wanna make sure that the color is evenly distributed, and I did not use very much candle wax. I cut off about a sliver of each, because like I said before, the pigments are pretty strong. The dyes for the candle wax are pretty strong, and you don't need a lot to change the color. So our wax is melted at this point, and the directions say to heat the wax to 185. It says don't heat above 185. So when your wax gets to 185 with this particular kit, we're gonna remove it from the double boiler and put it down on the trivet that comes with the kit so that it can cool down. So then we're just gonna pour it right into the container. So here we go. You wanna pour it slowly so that you don't get any air bubbles. Candles, especially soy, tends to be a little bit on the fickle side, so the more slowly you pour, the better result you're gonna get. It's important too, when you're pouring these, you don't want to over pour. You want to make sure that you have enough wick. Once you get one candle poured, you're just going to wipe out the excess candle wax. Don't put water in it, because the candle wax will get all gross and you won't be able to get it out. So you're going to wipe out the old wax and make sure it's clean, and then you're just going to repeat the process. Okay, so this is candle number two. We're at 185, so we're going to add our candle dye, and we're going to make sure that it is melted all the way. So candle number two is going to be our lavender. So I made this real pretty color just by cutting off some of the purple dye blocks. And again, I didn't use a ton, I just cut about a corner of it off is what I cut off of it to make that nice electric purple. It looks like an electric purple to me. We'll see what it looks like in the candle. And when you open these, you wanna make sure, because you're gonna use the whole bottle, so you don't need this white cap on it. Take that off so you can pour it. We're good at 170, so we're gonna pour this one. Let's use one of these rectangular ones this time for the lavender. Ooh, that's a pretty purple in the tin. So the wax goes into the candle tin, which goes onto the double boiler, which sits until the waxes melt at 185. And then once the waxes melt, we will pour in our dye. And they don't have it, again, it doesn't have to be a ton of this dye. Just a corner cut off of those dye blocks will work, because they're very concentrated. Then once we cool to 170, we'll add our fragrance and stir it for about 4 to 5 seconds, and then we're ready to pour again. And I have just added our color dye to this. And there you go, there's the dye for that one. It's pretty aquamarine color with a little bit of blue in it. And we are ready to pour. So we're just waiting on it to cool down to 170, and then we're going to add our fragrance and then we'll pour it. Our temperature is at 170, so we're going to now dump our fragrance in, and then we're going to stir for about 4 to 5 seconds, and then we're going to pour this last candle. Okay, there you have it. There's all four of our candles. So we have lavender here. This was cinnamon and vanilla. This was cotton clean, and this one is coconut lime. So we'll be back after tomorrow and we can see how our candles turned out. Okay, everybody, it's about 24 hours later. So we're going to see what we created yesterday. They turned out pretty nice, huh? This one is the cinnamon vanilla, coconut lime, lavender. And this one is the cotton clean. This one I left the wick on so I could show you that it's really easy just to snip this wick off. And you want to do that before you put the lids on because the wicks are too long for the lids to fit on. So then after they're all dry and you're ready to go, just put the lids on them and then attach your labels. I wish that I could show you what they would look like with the labels on them, but my printer is out of ink and I cannot find it. So for now, for this video, these won't have any labels on them, but you do have them in the description box and links to all the equipment. Here are some expert tips about candles. One, you need to make sure that your wick is trimmed to about 1/4 inch. If you don't have one of those fancy wick cutters, or if it's too deep down in the candle for you to trim with scissors, you can always use toenail clippers. The second thing that I want to make sure that you're aware of is you need to make sure you know the diameter of the candle. And the reason that you want to know the diameter of your candle is you should only burn it 1 hour each inch. So this candle is roughly 2.5 inches in diameter. So that means that you should only burn this candle for 2.5 hours at a time, okay? And the reason that you want to do that is because if you burn it longer than that, for one, you create the chance that you might catch something on fire. Two, your wick is going to be too long by then. Three, your candle is going to start throwing soot. And I don't know if you've ever burned candles before and you see this dark black ring around your candles. That is probably because you're burning your candles too long. So if it's 1 inch, do 1 hour. If it's 2 inches, do 2 hours, okay? So you need to give it a break in between. Tip number three is the first time that you burn your candle, make sure you burn it so that there's a wax pool all the way around. If you light your candle and you don't let it burn long enough to create the wax pool, then your candle will get what's called a memory burn. And the wax pool will only go as far as that first burn. Letting a candle burn all the way to the edge creates what's called a wax pool, and that's where the scent comes from in the candle. So if you get a memory burn, you won't have the full scent of your candle. So I'm curious to know if you knew any of those candle tips. When I first started making candles a few years ago, I knew about the wick thing, and that was it. I did not know anything about a memory burn, and I did not know that you were only supposed to burn it for 2 hours, and kept wondering why my candles were throwing so much soot everywhere every time I was burning them. I thought that the candles were either cheap or that it was the wrong kind of wax, but I probably was burning them too long. So I'm curious to know in the comments below whether or not you knew any of those tips.
I hope you had fun. The links to the kit and the equipment are down below, and make sure that you grab your labels.
If you haven't had a chance to watch them yet, there are 4 other videos on DIY projects that you might be interested in for this Christmas season. And if you have any questions or anything else I can answer for you, I can always be reached at teachmetracyt@gmail.com. That's it for this DIY. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.